friends, it's Gwen. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm here to do my January wrap-up, and I've decided to break down my wrap-ups at the end of the month a little bit differently for the year of 2021. I want to check, I have the chapters down in so you could skip around, you know, what you're really interested in. But I have the books here that I said I was going to read in January. So I had three poetry collections. These three. So I had Swimming Lessons, I had Dearly, and I had Immortalized in Ink. And as you guys know, because I put out an entire video about a poetry reading vlog, I did read Immortalized in Ink, so that will go into the books that I talked to you about. I did not read these, you guys, and I explained why in that video. So these are possibly moving over into February. I'm not really sure. All right, and then the books that I said I was gonna read are these. So Cover Your Tracks, read that one. Beasts of Extraordinary Circumstance, read that one. The Wife Upstairs by Rachel Hawkins, read that one. And the last one, These Violent Delights, I actually did start it. I made it here to page 83. That's where my bookmark is, and I DNF'd it, but I did give it a go, so we'll talk more about that in a minute. I didn't make a specific video talking about my goals. I did do an episode on my podcast about goals, but I never did like a sit-down video here on YouTube about it, so I thought I would just go through them quickly with you. I have mentioned them in several videos. I always set my Goodreads reading goal at 52 books. I also have a profile over on the StoryGraph, and I'm using that this year. All of the books that I have read so far in 2021, I have written reviews for, both on Goodreads and on StoryGraph. So if you're interested in more of my full thoughts of books that I really don't go into detail about, definitely check out those reviews. Okay, so I have a 2021 stats page in my bullet journal about the kinds of books, my rating, the age group, when it was published, the genre, and then I have my three main goals down here that I want to accomplish other than reading 52 books in a year, which I'll show you that in a minute. So I want to read 6 classics this year, 12 book of the months, and 12 new releases. And so far I have read 0 classics, 3 book of the months, and 2 new releases. So yay! And then moving on to my other goals, I have this page right here. So I picked out, how many was it? 7 backlist titles that I really wanted to get to, and I just printed out the book covers. These Violent Delights was one of the backlist titles that I wanted to get to. So I just indicated I tried it in January and I DNF'd it. So, and I have my 52 books in 2021, and you can see I'm coloring in the squares as I read books. So yeah, so as you can see, I am making progress on my goals, and that makes me very excited. Okay. Another DNF that I put on my DNF shelf is My Dark Vanessa. I actually started this in December, but then I put it down because I didn't want this to be the first book that I read in 2021. So I put it down and I read the book, and then I tried to go back to this and I was just not feeling it. So I also DNF'd this quite a few pages in. I was on page 78. Okay, so the very first book that I read this year is a reread, All Your Perfects by Colleen Hoover. You guys know how important this book is to me. I do read a lot of books in a year. I feel like sometimes little details get lost. I remember the big picture ideas, but I don't remember all of the details. But guys, this book, oh, I read it the first time, rated it 5 stars, read it in January. I read it on the 1st of January, all in one day, and I do not regret that decision. It started my year off right with a 5-star read, and I just will always talk about this book, and it's just such a great book, and I just love it so much. It deals with important topics. Triggers for infertility, cheating, miscarriage, and hysterectomy. Yeah, I love this book so much, and I do think it was a departure from some of her other stuff because it definitely deals with like harder topics, but it also has that like classic Colleen Hoover thrown in the mix. And Love this one. Next book that I read is The Wife Upstairs by Rachel Hawkins, and I read this for my book club, and it was the second book I read in the month, and I really liked this one as well. I rated this one 4 stars, and a lot of people are wondering, like, do you have to have read Jane Eyre? Because this is supposedly a Jane Eyre retelling. I've never read Jane Eyre, and I really, really enjoyed it. So it's about this dog walker that kind of gets another chance at a new life when she gets involved with one of this, like, really wealthy people in the neighborhood that she did the dog walking. And it's kind of like their romance, and then you get different perspectives, and you find out maybe everything isn't as it seems. I tried something outside my comfort zone. It's a fantasy, magical realism, Beasts of Extraordinary Circumstance. I didn't like this one. I thought that there wasn't, like, too much that happened, and I don't feel like we followed Waylon Gray as much as I wanted to. He was definitely the most interesting character, but instead of following him, you're following all of the other people in his life and how they have interacted with them through his life. A lot of people love this book, but I rated it 2 out of 5 stars. Again, all of my reviews are available on Goodreads and the Storygraph, so if you're interested in my full thoughts, definitely check out that review. Exhibit by Lauren Egert Crow, and I picked this up on recommendation from Jen Campbell, a booktuber, an author, a poet. She does all of the things, and I rated it 1 star. I think I was just too dumb for this or something. Like, I didn't like this at all. Then I picked up Cover Your Tracks by Dako S. Offenord. I had really, really high hopes for this one. I absolutely love the cover of this one. So, so, so pretty. This one follows Margot Fletcher. She's 8 months pregnant. She's on a train from, like, one city, Chicago, to Spokane. And I guess they're traveling along, and then the train stops, and there's going to be this avalanche. So one of the other passengers tries to tell everybody to get to the back of the train. Nobody listens to him except for Margot. And of course, an avalanche does come and takes out the entire train, and they are the only ones left standing because he was able to unhook the last car of the train, and they survive. But of course, there's no food, they need to get help, so they have to leave the train, and it's snowy, snowy conditions, avalanches are happening, there's wild animals, and so forth, and so you kind of find out why this happened, and it's told, and, like, you get a lot of their past, and you get, like, what's happening. It wasn't as action-packed as I wanted it to be, and the secrets that both characters are carrying are slowly, I mean, it's a short book, but I just felt like this was drug out, like, so long. And I did read the poetry collection Immortalized in Ink, and I do have that full video where I go in depth about why this one did not work for me. Next up, I read Watching You by Lisa Jewell. I had this on my TBR. I picked it up at the book exchange, and the audiobook was available on one of my library apps, so I picked it up at random. I rated it 3 stars. Nothing too great, nothing too horrible, just kind of okay. Since We Fell by Dennis Lehan. And guys, this book, whoa, mind-blowing, so great, so unassuming. Cover, so unassuming. But also, look, I kind of do match it today. I'm gonna do that intentionally. Okay, guys, this is a 5-star read. It is so good. I had, even from the synopsis, I really didn't understand, like, how good it was gonna be. And the blurb inside from Kristen Hanna says, "Once you pick up a Dennis Lehan novel, you're hooked. It's just that simple. Since We Fell is complex, compelling page turner of a novel from a master storyteller at the top of his game." And guys, I 100% agree. This book was so freaking good. Out of all of the books that I read this month, if I can convince you to give one book a shot, it is this one. This book is kind of like a thriller, mystery, action. Like, it starts off one way, and I was really, really interested in that part. I thought I was really interested from like page one to the very last page, but it kind of builds. It starts off like one way, and you're going down one avenue, and you're like, oh my gosh, this is so interesting. And then it like changes, and I just don't want to tell you too much about it, because like, if you obviously, if you've read it, you know what an amazing masterpiece this is. But if you haven't read it, even if you read the synopsis, like, you're not gonna understand like what a treat you're in for. This was my only 5-star read besides All Your Perfects, which was a reread, so I kind of knew it was gonna be 5 stars. This was my only 5-star read of the year so far, guys. And then we dive into romance world, and I read so much romance, you guys. Okay, so the next one that I read is The Honey Don't List by Christina Loren, and I'm sure you guys know what this one is about, but it's basically like you're following the assistance of Chip and Joanna Gaines. That's what this book is, and it's their romance story. So if you go into it for it being like the Chip and Joanna story, no. It's their assistance love story. So I liked it a lot more than I thought I was going to, because a lot of people did not vibe with this, and I thought it was pretty good. I actually gave it 4 stars, so yeah, it actually worked for me. Next up, I decided to pick up the second and the third books in the Bromance Book Club series, and you know that I loved the first one, The Bromance Book Club by Lissa K. Adams. So I read Undercover Bromance by Lissa K. Adams, and what's this one called? Crazy Stupid Bromance by Lissa K. Adams. And these were both sent to me for Christmas from members of my book club. I am so grateful for my book club and the members, and just they are always showering me with love and praise, and it's so nice to be surrounded by people that just like lift you up rather than like rip you down all the time. Anyway, so Undercover Bromance, I didn't actually have a lot of high hopes for, because again, like The Honey Don't List, I was like, a lot of people didn't like that, but a lot of people didn't like this, and I really liked it. I rated it 4 stars. It definitely tackles hard topics like the Me Too movement, and I know that that's like super important, and I love when authors can weave important topics into their books, but I didn't necessarily know it was gonna focus so much more on that. I thought it was gonna be more romance with the side of Me Too, but it was more like Me Too with the side of romance. So it just depends what you're in the mood for, but I really, really enjoyed it, and I rated it 4 stars. I couldn't just leave the third book unread on my bookshelf. I mean, how cute is this cover, you know? But I really, really like this one. This one also dealt with kind of harder topics as well, and it focused more on those than the actual romance itself. And I mean, that's okay. This one is about a cafe store owner that finds out she has a sister, and that her dad needs a kidney, and she could possibly be a match. So it's more about those family dynamics of like family you didn't really even know you had, and should she do this? Should she be tested? Does she belong? Is she a part of that family, or anything? So it's more about that, and then there's like a side of romance, but I wish it was more romance focused. I ended up rating this one 3 out of 5 stars because yeah, it just didn't do it as well as the first or the second book. But I'm really looking forward to the Russians book, because like in these books, I really did get to know the Russian character Vlad a little bit more. I always say the Russian because that's how they refer to him in these books. They're always like, the Russian. So that's why I always call him the Russian. But yeah, so I'm definitely excited about the fourth book in the series that releases later this year. Niece by Christina Loren, which I rated this one 2 stars. This is about a young girl that lives in New York City. Her uncles also live in New York City, and they work, one of the uncles works as like the director of this really popular Broadway show, and the main actor and the lead musician in the show are leaving the show, and so he needs to find a new musician, a new lead actor, and they have found the new lead actor, but they haven't found the musician. Well, the girl, the main girl, what's her name again? Holland. She has always been fascinated and she kind of has a crush on this street musician, and she recommends the street musician to her uncle. So long story short, they call him in. They end up really, really liking him. They offer him the job, but he is in the country illegally. So she ends up marrying him so he can get his documentation that he needs to stay in the country and work on this show. And it's their romance story. So next up, I read my favorite Half Night Stand by Christina Loren. The next one is Dating You, Hating You. If you were interested in more of my full thoughts about these, I did an entire reading vlog reading all of these and sharing all of my thoughts. So you can definitely check out that reading vlog when I eventually put it up for you guys. And then I'm hoping to do a ranking Christina Loren books because I have read quite a few now. And then the last book that I want to talk to you about this month is The X Talk by Rachel Lynn Solomon. This was one of my most anticipated books of the year. I ended up rating this 3 out of 5 stars. And this is about, again, it's very much like Dating You, Hating You. It's an office place romance story about these two characters that he is more like journalistic, like he really wants to be into like that hard-hitting journalism, and she just wants to tell stories to people and like connect with people. Well, the radio show, radio network or whatever, what is it? Yeah, the public radio station that they work for is kind of under a little bit of trouble. Like their shows aren't doing as good as they used to do. And their boss is getting rid of one of the shows that she works on. And they decide that they need something new and fresh to kind of like bring new listeners in. And she comes up with the idea of like this podcast, and she is having trouble like dating and stuff like that. She's like, what if we do like a dating one? Like maybe we have like 2 exes go on and talk about like relationship advice and stuff. And the boss loves it. And he's like, perfect, you two are gonna do it. And she's like, what the heck, we weren't even dating. So the boss says, yes you did, you dated, you broke up, now you're doing the show. So it's kind of like this whole ruse about these two people that have never dated, that they kind of lie. You know, they set it up between all of their friends and on the air that they like dated, and now they've broken up, so they have to like get to know each other. And of course, as they get to know each other and work alongside each other, and of course he's hot and she's pretty, you know, they end up together. But yeah, so I don't know, I don't like that they had to lie about it. I mean, I get it, but I don't know. Oh, anyway. So those are the books that I'm going to talk to you about. I did read 2 other books this month, but I'm going to wait to talk to you about them next month. But I hope you enjoyed the new layout of my wrap-ups. So let me know what you thought about this new format to my wrap-ups at the end of the month. And let me know if I have convinced you to pick up any of the books that I have talked about. And let me know what the best book you read this month was. And you're having a wonderful day or night, and I'll see you guys again next time. Bye!